Guideline 2.2 enough time pertains to whenever you add time limits to user interactions. And what you should do is, if you have to add a time limit, you should always have the option of the user being able to pause the time limit or extend it unless the time limit is more than 20 hours. Now you might be thinking, well, Stephanie, what if I have a website like eBay that has auctions in real time? Well, in this case, it is permissible not to add time limits or to allow users to pause, because that would totally defeat the purpose. However, a lot of sites add time limits for no reason whatsoever, or they add time limits in order to force the users to complete a purchase or take actions, making them feel like if they don't do it, for example, in like 7 minutes, they're going to miss out. And this is a dark pattern, and this is very bad. And most of the time limits I've seen are useless, and they're only done, you know, to increase sales in a really bad way. Here's an example of Eventbrite. Let's say I want to buy tickets for cookies with Santa, because this seems like a totally ordinary thing a 26-year-old adult would do. So let me go into tickets. And let's say, yes, I'm over 13 years old. Let's do checkout. And there we go. See how there is a time left and you have 7 minutes to complete your purchase for no reason, because I haven't seen anywhere that the tickets are limited. And if the tickets really were limited, then you should have a live auto-updating feed saying how many tickets are left. So for this to be accessible, what they have to do is have a pause button and extend the time limit. And that would be it to me, you know, to make it accessible. They don't have either of those, but they just have the time limit just to pressure people. And this can be really, really bad for people with an anxiety disorder or someone who, you know, uses a screen reader or uses a braille refresher display, and they cannot operate an interface as quickly as someone using the mouse or something else. So this is why, you know, time limits are really bad, and you should avoid using them at all costs. But if you absolutely have to, then you should take that into account. Another success criterion is for interruptions, and you shouldn't interrupt the person's, you know, flow. And this happens if you use the meta refresh element, which so this one will reload the page after 60 seconds. And you shouldn't do that, because, you know, that would break the user's flow. And if you absolutely have to do that, then you should be very clear on the screen after how many seconds this is going to refresh, and you should also allow the users to extend or pause the refresh. And this is true for, you know, one of those screens where you like submit, where you, let's say you submit a contact form, and then the message appears like you will be redirected to the homepage in 3 seconds. So that's also bad. You should make sure that you allow users to pause, and you just don't take control of the user's workflow and their computer. Just make them do their own thing. You never know who's using your platform, and that's the problem. Nowadays, QA engineers and testers, they're all able people, usually young people, who only care, you know, about, they think every user has their abilities, their youth, and, you know, oh, I don't mind if that page is going to redirect me without telling me. And that's not true. But you should test diversity. You should test with a lot of diversity, not just with like very few people. So yeah, this is level A. Then we have another level A, which is success criterion, pause, stop, and hide. So you should be able to control the time limit. Then afterwards, we have triple A is no timing. So you should have absolutely no timing of a user to complete an action, and that will ensure triple A conformance. Then we have triple A about interruptions. They can be postponed or suppressed. So a great example is, if you guys have Windows, you know how Windows always gives you an option, oh, you should update your Windows. Would you like to do it now, or 15 minutes later, or a day later? So this is good. This covers the postponing thing for the criterion. And then suppress means, for example, you can say, remind me later, or just don't do it at all. So this is really good. Unless there's an emergency, so you can interrupt the user unless there's an emergency, so that's neat. And then reauthentication is, so have you ever like filled in a really long form or did something on a site, and then suddenly your user session has expired and you have to do it all over again? So this is what it means. It means always remember user sessions, and then when you re-authenticate them, I can't pronounce that word, then make sure that you remember, make sure that the system remembers where they're out to. And then the timeouts, because timeouts, it's not impossible, it is not possible not to have any timeouts. For example, for banking systems, they need to have timeouts, but you have to make it in a way that they are warned, and you know, any data that you can save after the timeout should be saved, and any data that cannot be saved, for example, some cookies or in a banking app, then you should tell the user, okay, so you're trying to transfer money, but after 20 minutes when you time out, then you have to populate the money you want to transfer between your accounts. So always make sure that you're very upfront with the user in order to cover the success criterion for timeouts.